Lily here with the one and the only father of Vergil Ortiz Sr. Vergil has a fight coming up August 10th. Mm-hmm. You're one of the three people in his corner. What do you think him training now, what is he exactly working on to take on this such a battle against Relentless Orozco?
Well, Vergil is pretty much almost doing the same thing he does for every fight. He's training to go the distance, either at a high pace or a low tempo or whatever it is. Just more on being himself. That's pretty much it. I mean, everything has always stayed the same. He can adapt to pretty much almost every style. So we're really just working on just his technique, his combinations, and just his stamina.
As a trainer, you obviously see what Relentless can do and what he has done against his other opponents. What do you think is his biggest strength? You as a trainer, what do you see are his biggest strengths coming up into this fight against Vergil?
Well, actually, what his nickname says, Relentless. He comes, he can take a shot, and he'll exchange with you. And sometimes it looks like he'll take even two or three shots to give you one of his good shots. So a guy like that, he's dangerous because what he'll want to do is he'll try to push you to his tempo. So I see for him as a threat, I'd see is someone that can keep that keeps coming, tries to enforce his will, and makes you try to fight his fight.
Now, what do you think you guys can capitalize on his mistakes?
Well, I wouldn't say mistakes because I would just say more of habits. Everybody has their own habits. The key is just to decode what everybody else does repeatedly, because anybody can make a mistake. You never know what mistake it is, because a mistake is a mistake. It's just you just never know what a mistake is. So it's more you try to focus on the habits that somebody has. But really, I mean, it's just take what he gives you. That's pretty much it. Just take what he gives you, and that's pretty much it.
Vergil had a tremendous fight against Mauricio Herrera. Mm-hmm. Though a lot of people, like Vergil said, don't give him credit for that because they say Herrera was old. But Herrera has been rugged his whole fighting career. What do you think this fight proves for Vergil?
This fight, really, for us, okay. So for us, it doesn't prove anything because we already know what Vergil is. For the casual fan, they're probably going to say, oh, well, he's the real deal. But people that are in boxing that are actually professionals in it for a very long time, it really doesn't prove too much. It just kind of seals it for them, like we already know. So it doesn't do anything too much for us. It's just another fight for him, and that's how we see it. We don't try to say, oh, it's a because this guy has this record, because a lot of times the record isn't what the person is. And sometimes, like Mauricio has his last few fights, he has lost them. But just look who he's fought. Look how he's fought the guys, how he's given them trouble. So
just look at the Danny Garcia fight.
Yeah, his record doesn't speak for the talent that he has, because Mauricio is actually a very difficult person to fight. I mean, even though Vergil made it look like the way he did, but people don't understand, Vergil, when he trains, He trains very hard, and not only does he train very hard, but I stay up nights, I'm talking about 4 o'clock in the morning, reading these guys. When I mean reading is trying to dissect, I can watch the same video over 1,000 times, and you just look at their feet, one video, just their arms, just their head movement. I look at every different part of the body a bunch of times, and that's pretty much all it is that it's a lot of work behind the scenes. So really, that's pretty much really it right there. That's why he makes it look like the way it is, because he does everything that he's supposed to a T, and he follows through the game plan.
You have, like I said, three people besides yourself in Vergil's corner. Was it hard to let your son go to another person instead of just being the son and pops team?
No, for me, it's not very hard to let him go. And I don't really see him as going, because I'm still there. But I always tell people, when people ask me this question or any kind of question related, I always see it like this. I see it as a father, and I see it as a coach. As a father, what kind of father would I be if I just only trained my son, knowing that he could get a different point of view, see it, maybe understand something else better from a different way? Because if I'm sending my son in there pretty much to war, is what I am. And this is a war, this is a sport that you can die from. So if I'm going to risk my son's life intentionally, because that really is intentionally, not intentionally to hurt him,
but it can happen,
and you're holding that for him. What kind of father am I? As a coach, what kind of coach would I be to sit here and not let this kid learn more from somebody else, and to, you know, to the point where hopefully, you know, when he retires, he's straight. He doesn't have any kind of health problems and, you know, or brain damage or anything like that. That's somebody that cares for you. And if it means me even stepping to the side and let somebody that actually can handle him better, then so be it. But I'm always going to be there, because at the end of the day, I'm still his dad. I'll still want what's best for him, even if it means me stepping to the side, which I'm always, because that's what a person that cares, not even a father, but somebody who cares for that person would do. So that's how I look at things. I look at things as for my son's health.
Lastly, I know you guys train to go the distance, but Vergil has not gone the distance to any of his fights. He hasn't even gone past the fifth round. What is your prediction for this fight? Especially, like you say, Relentless Orozco is relentless for a reason, but being relentless kind of leaves you open for counters in a way. Mm-hmm. Do you think Vergil can capitalize on that and make it an early night, especially like we see with his body shots? Or what's your prediction for this fight?
I don't really have a prediction, and the reason I say this is not because I try to be nice. I never look at the knockout. I always look to go the distance. So I never try to predict like that. Now I might have a feeling once he's fighting, like in there, and like I can start reading,
in a round.
Usually in the first round, I can tell in the first round what's going to happen. I tell him, and we're usually pretty much in sync on it. But I mean, yeah, if the guy's coming to you, you know, he's kind of letting you open himself up a little bit, but at the same time you're kind of in the fire, in the way of fire, so it goes both ways. So I try not to really predict, because in the way I kind of think it's bad luck in the way. So I really don't do that stuff, because then if I do predict,
you jinx it.
Well, that and all that, but then my son could possibly go looking for it, and if you go looking for something, sometimes you're looking when something else is looking for you, you're not paying attention. So I try not to predict, and I just let it go like that.
Okay, this brings me to another question. You talk about making sure your son makes, you know, you're giving him the right instructions. Now we see with a lot of up-and-coming fighters, and if they're with their father especially, sometimes the father talks a little too much for them. So then do you think that maybe creates a pressure on the fighter to basically do what the dad is telling everybody else that his son can do? For example, I'm just going to name it out there, Teofimo Lopez. His dad says, you know, my son can beat Lomachenko. Teofimo says it too. But his dad is very, very, you know, vocal about Teofimo being able to beat Lomachenko and doing all of this. That sometimes you think as a son and a fighter, you think they feel even more pressure to do that because their father is selling them to be like this?
Well, I'll say this. And you can probably much say every son is going to pretty much, when it comes to stuff like that, don't really have a choice to. And what I mean by don't have a choice is that they're going to back their fathers up or their parents up, regardless of they're right or wrong, because this is a respect thing. They respect their parents, and that's what they're going to do. But I would say it's more pressure in a way, but at the same time, it might not be because maybe they're used to them being like that. But I personally don't do it, and the reason I don't do it is because my time will come, and my son's time will come. You know, whenever he's on this big stage, it's going to come if you talk or if you don't talk. It's going to be there. And not only that, but let's say, you know, you're putting him out to be something so big, and this is boxing. One punch changes everything, and God forbid, one punch changes. Can you imagine because the internet is so cruel now,
yeah.
Can you imagine the outrage is going to end, and the backlash that will come to you and stuff like that? Believe it or not, it does wear on people, and it does get to them. And so why would I want to put, again, I love my son so much, why would I want to put him in a situation like that? Not only that, but I've also been taught, and I've always felt that that you don't have to talk. Well, first of all, you know, my son mentioned, you know, where I come from, how I grew up.
Yeah.
Where I come from, we don't have to talk to be what we are. We are who we are. And if we have to talk to be what we're supposed that we are, then more likely we're probably not it. That's not what we are. So usually the best thing is, you know, be who you are. Whatever comes. You can handle it. That's how we are.
All right. If you want people to follow you on Instagram, where can they find you?
I'm Vergil Ortiz Sr., SR.
Senior SR. Okay. Don't forget to catch Vergil Ortiz Jr.'s fight August 10th from DAZN.